What's up, C-Dub fam? It's your boy, Nurse CW. We're back with another video. Boy, we're bringing back some heat today. Happy Sunday, you guys. We woke up this morning. What a great Sunday. So before we get this video started, go ahead and like, comment, and subscribe. Go ahead and tell your mama, your daddy, your auntie, your uncle, your little cousin, your step cousin, your stepsister, stepbrother, half-sister, half-brother, half-sister, friend, daddy, great-grandma, your bald-headed babysitter. Go ahead and tell all them folks right now to go ahead and follow your boy, Nurse CW. So go ahead and hit that subscribe button right below, right there. Go ahead and do that right now. And if you guys are new to my channel, my name is Nurse CW. This is a vlogging channel for you guys, for your nursing brother, the one who you will always love and forever will love. And I'm here just bringing some heat, you guys. So today's video, if you are a nursing student, today's video is going to be a video on how to pass and study for your HESI assessment. So if you guys do not know, a HESI assessment is basically an assessment that nursing students have to take before applying to nursing school. It's an assessment that is given by like the nationwide, you know, nursing schools, colleges, all that good stuff. Just basically to test your basic knowledge of certain things like your math, your English skills, your reading skills, and your anatomy skills. You know, all that good stuff. So basically, I'm here to bring you three tips and study tools that I basically use. So one of the study tools that I did use was, of course, our good friend YouTube. I Googled and YouTube some of every and all videos about the HESI exam and how to study for the HESI exam. I looked up different YouTubers like the Nurse Nook, Nurse Muse, Nurse Blake, and all that good stuff. Like, YouTube is a great friend, so we might as well use it. Millions of people are on it every day. It gave me tips, it gave me like routines, it gave me study strategies, all that good stuff. The second tool that I use, you guys, was Google. I simply typed in HESI practice test, HESI exam, what to expect from the HESI, all those good things. I read, looked up, so many things that my head was hurting. By the time I even took the HESI, I felt like I was the HESI. You get what I'm saying? So, So basically, I typed in like HESI prep, HESI practice exams, and basically, there is a website called HESI assessment test or something like that. And basically, it has like different categories and subjects that you can take on the HESI or whatnot. And basically, it gives you practice tests. These practice tests are not exactly like the exam. However, they do prepare you and prep you for the exam of how, when you do take the test, you will know how to answer the question. They give explanations if you give the question wrong. If you get the question right, it will turn green. Beep, 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 beep. And if you get it wrong, red X. That's exactly what it will do. The third thing, which I consider my best friend to be for the HESI was my HESI A2 study guide. It's a 2018-2019 version, and this was given from the company Apex. Or not given, but I bought it from the company Apex, and I basically got this study guide from Amazon. As you guys can see, I order a lot of things off of Amazon. Amazon is my best friend, so I will leave the link in the description box for this study guide right here. Now, for me personally, I know there's a lot of study guides out there, but for me personally, this was one of the ones that helped me the best. It broke down everything. It had practice tests, pre-test, post-test in it. It gave explanations. It told you why your answer was right, why your answer was wrong. It gave, like I said, it breaks down the test into the four different categories that you do have to take, which was the math, the anatomy, the reading, and the English. So basically, yeah, I bought this book, this one right here, as you can see, this nice blue one. I bought this for, I would say, under $20. I do know that you can get it at your local bookstores like Barnes & Noble's, Books & Million, all those good things. And like I said, they have millions of versions of HESI A2 study guides. So just basically look up the one and read the reviews. Please read reviews, and also read reviews on YouTube, or look at reviews on YouTube. That also helped me a lot for the people who said that they passed their HESI exam. I'm sorry, you guys. It's pollen season in Atlanta. If you guys do not know Atlanta, during springtime, the pollen is hitting right now. We had a late winter, and it's messing your boy up. Do you hear me? It's really messing your boy up. So, So basically, now that I gave you the three tools that I use, actually, you know what? I'm gonna be nice to y'all because I actually have a fourth tool, and I'm usually not this nice. You understand me? Like, I'm your brother, so that what that means is basically sometimes I like you, sometimes I don't like you, but I'm just here to always love you. That's all that matters. We're family. Don't mean I always like you, but I love you. So I'm gonna be nice today. So another fourth tool that I use, I don't know if you're familiar with it or if you're not familiar with it, but if you are, and if you're not, you need to get familiar with it. It's called Quizlet. Q-U-I-Z-L-E-T, quiz and let go, let live, let all that, you know what I'm saying? Quizlet. Quizlet would be one of your best friends, you guys. Literally all I did was go on Google, I would type in what I was looking for, and at the end of what I was looking for, I would put Quizlet. And literally, Quizlet would basically send you to the link of the app itself, basically show you all these usernames, and these usernames are these people out here, these people who are here to help you and provide you with this information. Basically, they created their own study guides, and you can study their study guides, and basically it breaks down the study guide into like games you can play, flashcards, practice tests, and all that to help you prepare for any test or homework assignment that you're needing help in. Y'all, I'm giving this is free knowledge. Like, I didn't have a lot of people to do this for me. Luckily for the three tools, luckily for internet, without internet, I don't even know. Internet and YouTube, I do not know where we would be. That's why there is a such thing as YouTube University, because you can literally get a degree on how to do something from YouTube. So basically, now that we have the three tools, let's actually go into the book. So basically, the first section that I took was the math portion. You guys, I don't know if you guys love math, but your brother does not like math. I cannot stand math. I don't like the look of math. I don't like the name of math. I don't like the first name or the last name of math. I don't even like the middle initial, which is A, in math. Like, I don't like math. I don't like the ma and the tus in math. You get what I'm saying? Like, I just don't like math. So, like, literally, I would be that kid who gets all A's, and then next thing you know, you get a which the is that B, and that B is in math. Math. That's what it's in. Math. Like, it's not in science. It's not in English. It's not in writing. It's not even in boring history. It's in math. And I'm just like, guys, like, I would study all the time. I would take my test, still make 80s. I'm like, I'm just going to accept the fact that math is not my best friend. It's not my cousin. It's not my mother. It's not even the baby, bald-headed babysitter that I keep telling y'all to subscribe to. Or for them to subscribe to me. Like, it's not them. It's not it. It's not for me. But for your HESI assessment, you have to take the math portion. Now, I will give you a breather. The math portion is not no pre-cal type stuff. It's not like no trigonometry. It's not none of that. It's basic like stuff that you would need that you can use potentially in your nursing career. So you do need to know like ratios and proportions. You do need to know conversions. Conversions are a big one, you guys. I don't even know if y'all had the little tin man where it had cups right here, cups right there, pints right there, pints right there. What else? Quarts and quarts, gallon for the body or whatnot. I don't know if y'all had that growing up in elementary and middle school, but we had that where we stay at in Atlanta, so we had the little chart man. Go ahead and look that up. That's going to be your best friend. You need to get to know him. Go ahead and name him Bob, Billy, Bat, name him. That's going to be your best friend. What else? Roman numerals. I know that seems kind of crazy. Like, why would you need to know Roman numerals? But you need to know a little of Roman numerals. Some of my peers, they didn't have Roman numerals. They said on their test. However, I did have one to two questions on Roman numerals. Another thing, you guys, for the math portion, which might seem kind of crazy because you feel as though, like, yeah, we're in the medical field. Why do we need to know military time? Well, if you do not know in a hospital or in a medical facility, you would be telling time and using time in military time. So go ahead and get yourself familiar with 1500, 1542, 1613. Go ahead and get yourself familiar with those times. Go ahead and set your clock or your phone, your iPhone, your Google Nexopixel. Go ahead and your Android, your Samsung Galaxy. Go ahead and set your phone or your tablet or your iPad to that time, military time, because I did have a few questions on military time, which all of these things are in these study guide books. I don't know how in depth they go in them, but my book surely did tell me how to go to how to study Roman numerals and how to study military time. It did do that. It did a great job at that. The book did do a good job of breaking down proportions and fractions and ratios from a word problem. It did a good job on it and showing me how to do it, giving explanations. However, your boy stresses a lot. Like, I'm a crammer, first of all. I literally studied for this test and passed the test within 1 week of time. However, do not be like me. And please watch YouTube videos. So if you're reading something about the math portion that you're not getting, go to YouTube. You, like I said, YouTube is your best friend. I'm your best friend. I'm more than your best friend. I'm your brother because I love you. That's why I'm giving you this information. So if you're watching my video right now, just know that I love you. You love me. And we're here together. This is love. This is real love right here. You don't get this everywhere. Only at NurseCW channel. So, yes, you guys, please go to YouTube. Use your resources. If you have old notes that you crammed in your closet from second grade and it has conversions on it, read those. If you got notes that you never took from your high school teacher but you stole from somebody next to you, use those notes. Literally, they will help you. Also know your basics. Addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, long division, fractions, mixed fractions, improper fractions, how to divide fractions, how to multiply fractions, how to add fractions, how to subtract fractions. You guys, please refresh your memory. Least common denominator, least common factor, least common multiple. Know these things, you guys. This is what you would expect from the math portion. I'm not giving you no answers, I'm not giving you no material, but I'm trying to simply give you tips on how to pass your HESI exam on the first try. Next, we're going to go into reading. So the reading portion was basically like your standardized test that you see with reading. Your CRCT, your graduation test, your ACT, SAT type reading stuff. That's exactly how it's set up. You guys, so I know you guys are probably wondering, like, so how did they teach you or how can you study reading in a study guide book? Well, there's a lot that you need to know. You need to know how to basically not really know how to read a whole passage, but how to basically break down and dissect a passage to where you can annotate it and answer your question. So if it's asking the main idea, usually main ideas are usually located from the first and second sentence. You can easily, boom, you don't have to read the whole passage to know the main idea of the passage. Sometimes read the first two sentences to the last two sentences or last four sentences of the passage to get a main idea basis about the passage that you're reading. Sometimes in reading the app, also to infer different words, so they give you like some big word like prestidigitation, where I don't even know still to this day. I know it was off of Achilles and a B. I don't know what it means, but it might ask you, what is a synonym for prestidigitation? You need to try to use your context clues, your big old brain that you got in here, that right lobe, the frontal lobe, the parietal lobe, occipital lobe. You need to take all them lobes that is found in your big old skull that you have and apply infer. Guess you guys, I do not have a wide range of vocabulary. I know enough words to have a very intellectual conversation with somebody. So if I need to go from Nurse CW to A Trey, all this, that, and that, I can do that. I can turn on and off. That's what you guys need to know. So basically, you need to infer certain things from a passage. You do not have to be the smartest person in the world to infer. You get what I'm saying? Sometimes just thinking. Basic knowledge take your long way. Common sense take your long way. You know what I'm saying? You gotta always have book smarts. If you can have common sense, it takes you a long way as well. I'm not telling you that you don't need book smarts, but you do need both to correlate with having a successful mind. You know what I'm saying? So basically infer. That's how you can get those key vocabulary words that you never heard of before. Also know, look out for emotion, tone in the passage. Know those type of things. If you're looking out for tone and message, tone and mood, and the sound of voices, if the tone of the passage is angry and it gives you an underlying vocabulary word, sometimes you can look at a vocabulary word and means, oh, all these A, B, and C represent happiness and joy, but D is the only one that does it. So this probably correlates to the angry tone that's in the reader's voice. So things like that. Moving on to the next section, English. So English, you need to know things. It was very simple for me. I would say it should be simple for you. It's like I said, it's like those standardized tests. So you will see like subject, verb, agreement, and things like that. You'll see your nouns, your pronouns. You will see propositions. You need to know things like that. Basically like your basic high school, basic SAT, ACT, middle school, CRCT type stuff. You need to know like simple things. Like people do get confused on the whole thing with like the words of effect and effect or then and then. like people do or us or we're, like they don't, you know, sometimes it's hard for people to know when to use which pronoun. So you guys, please refresh your memory on things like that and you will be successful in the English part. It's not hard, you can take your time. Boom. Anatomy. Boy, I don't even know what to tell y'all about anatomy. Your boy didn't do so swell on anatomy. I did make a 70-something on anatomy part. I was not happy about it, but I can't. Hey, what can I say? At the time, I only took anatomy 1. I did not yet take anatomy 2. So your boy was clueless. My anatomy section, basically, there was a lot of anatomy 2 stuff. I can say with this book, a con about the book is that it does prep you and it does give you a generalization of the anatomy portion. So it does skim through each thing, but it does not go into full detail of what you need to know if you do have anatomy 2 questions on your test. So what I would say is, if you have your great friend here, which you guys should have, it costs a lot of money, like close to $200-$300 if you're in college right now, is your anatomy and physiology book. So even if you're in anatomy physiology 1, please go ahead and go to anatomy physiology 2 stuff and material in your book. It's okay to read. It's okay to further your education and further your knowledge and your wisdom prior to you taking a class. Sometimes that's the best thing to do. So if you have downtime in the summertime, go ahead and read the stuff that you would be reading that's required for next semester. Like, go ahead and do that. I would say, so please, you guys, please go over. If you're in anatomy 1 right now and you're taking your test before you get to anatomy 2, look over anatomy 2 stuff. And if you're in anatomy 2 and you don't really remember anatomy 1 stuff, go ahead and go back to anatomy 1 and go back to anatomy 2 and study together. You will be successful in anatomy portion of the SE exam. So that's basically breaking down the tools and stuff. Now let's get into my scores. So what your boy made, so first of all, at my school at the University of West Georgia, which is located in Carrollton, Georgia, the median average was 75 in each category, which if you get a 75 and all that, obviously gives you a composite score of 75. Your boy made an 80, so I made like a couple 80s between, I made like different 80s, they deferred, or they varied basically between English, math, and reading. Like, I know reading, I probably had like an 87. Math, I had like 85. English, like 80 something. And then I had like a 70 something in anatomy, which gave me the composite score of an 80. So, it was like a low 72. So I was kind of disappointed because I was really worried that I wasn't going to get into nursing school based off my HESI score, because I know some peers of mine who have gotten 90s, 95, 98s. And I also know some who've gotten lower than an 80 and still gotten in. So basically, it's just basically just, you know, just giving it an all, giving your best. I can say if you are a student who currently works, you can work and still study for the HESI exam. Don't be like your brother. Don't be like Nurse CW and cram the last minute. I literally crammed with a week and a half and it was crazy. It was straight crazy. I would not advise anybody to do it. If anything, I would advise you to at least give yourself 2 to 3 months, even a month. Even like 3 weeks, I would say 2 weeks, 2.5 weeks, but do not give yourself, I would say give yourself 2.5 to 3 weeks if you're a person who's like, you know, you guys still retain some of this information. If you're a person who is completely clueless, go ahead and give yourself 2 to 3 months. I only gave myself a week and I was clueless to the math part and I was clueless to some of the anatomy part, obviously. However, I did very well in the math and did very terrible in anatomy. But I still passed, so it doesn't matter. Your boy got that B average, that 80, that composite of that 8 and 0. 8 and 0, 8-0, 80. You get what I'm saying? I don't even know how to say it in Spanish, because if I did, I just would have said it. 8-cento? 8-cuento? I don't know. I don't know. I haven't took Spanish in a long time, so I don't even know how to say it. But yes, you guys, do not be like me. Do not be that person that's on the test like, woo, 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 and then you like, I don't know, I ain't gonna pass my test, I don't know, I should've studied, I should've listened to Brother Nurse CW, what was I thinking, I'm studying at the last minute, I only got 2 days to study. Don't be like me. Be that person like, yeah, man, I just wanted to, you come about that thing, you like, mama, I passed that test, daddy, I passed that test, grandma, I passed that test. Where the $50 at? Where the $100 at? Where the $10 at? Where's my stethoscope? Where's my car? Where's my apartment? You get what I'm saying? Be that. Be st- study to the point where you go into that test and you're going to Rocky Balboa that thing. Right hook, right hook. Oh, this is my left hand. Left hook, right hook, jab, 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 duck, bob, weed. Like, that's how you want to take that test. If it's throwing you a ratio, you da-da-da-da-da. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's how you want to be on this test. You do not want to be that person on that test and you're still on question number 3 and 2 hours then went by. Do not be that person. You guys, like, I didn't ramble a lot, but this is what family do. So I'm just here to let you know that a lot of these tests, first of all, I want to let y'all know something. And y'all can beat me up because we family and y'all can tear my head off. But let me let y'all know something. I just want y'all to know that I really love y'all because let me say, one thing about family, we might not always like each other and we might do like each other sometimes, but one thing about it, we will always love each other. So this information that I'm giving y'all is because I love y'all. And then you gotta think, I really do love y'all. Like, y'all just do not understand. Like, I'm giving y'all this information, you know what I'm saying? Your brother loves you guys. I want you guys to be successful nursing students. I want you guys to come to me with questions, come to me with feedback, come to me like, Nurse CW, can you please give us more information? Like, I just need, like, I thank you because I connected with you. Like, I understand, you get what I'm saying? Because like I said, there's not many people who really know the stresses that nursing students go through. Like, it is stressful, it is hard, your mind goes crazy. And on top of that, you have to take tests before even becoming a nursing student, like the HESI. With your undergraduate classes like man microbiology, the lab practicals, the lecture test, like they do not know you have a test every week, like they do not understand. And then you have a test like the HESI, but you still have exams and finals in your regular classes that you have to still study for. Like, it's so much stress, you guys, but it's worth it all. And you guys can do it. I love you guys. And like I said, we're gonna end this video off. Please give this video a thumbs up. We're gonna leave off with a do have love, family, or respect. And like I said, you guys go ahead and like, comment, and subscribe. And please tell and spread the news to other people. Like I said, your daddy, your mom, your cousin, your granddaddy, your little sister, your little brother, your big brother, your stepbrother, and your bald-headed babysitter. Please let everybody know. Please give feedback. Please comment, you guys. I love constructive criticism. I'm here to grow. Like I said, this is my third video. Just my third one. Like, I'm working on it, you guys. I haven't been posting, like, every day, but I'm still trying to grow into this business of YouTube. I'm not used to it, and you guys, I'm still a nursing student. So, literally, I have a quiz tomorrow on a digestive system, which I haven't even studied for because I am a crammer. So, I will be up all night. I do not drink coffee, but I will be energized on orange juice and oranges and fruit and all that good stuff, celery, kale. And yes, you guys, if you have not already, go ahead and check the first two videos out, which my first one was A Nurse About Me, Nurse CW and the C-Dub Family, and my second video, which was the unboxing of the Litman stethoscope, which I'm super happy about, you guys. And I love you guys. Come join me on my journey for nursing school. I will have future videos coming up, like nurse morning routine, skincare, night skincare for nurses, nursing meal preps, everyday life of nursing. I will be getting my CPR license soon, so I do need to take a class for that. Or like I said before, orientation is coming up, so I will bring you guys along with that. Like I said, we are a family, and we will always end off our videos with love, family, and respect. And like I said, one time for the do have.